Hi, Carrie here from My Quick Bookkeeping. In a previous video, I walked you through the steps to import your credit card transactions. Today, I'm going to show you what to do with them.
Here we are at the dashboard. Select Banking in the left-hand margin. Then select the account that you've imported the transactions for. As you can see, I'm going to be doing my TD US dollar Visa. I've selected this one as I recently started using it for my business. So there'll be a mix of personal and business, and I can show you what to do with them. Now I know that I've reconciled this card up to April 14th, so anything imported before that date has been accounted for. So I'm going to scroll down to the bottom and just see what's here. Here we have three transactions before that prior reconciliation date. Normally this wouldn't be something that would happen, but I've just started using this for business, so these are old things, I need to exclude them. If you've used your card for a mixture of business and personal and you're not going to be reconciling your account, then this is what you would do to get rid of any of those personal transactions. So now I'm going to scroll back up to the top, and under the batch actions, I'm going to exclude those selected transactions. They've now gone. Okay, so let's have a look at these transactions that QuickBooks has matched. What QuickBooks has done on the import is it looked at what it's brought in compared to what is sitting in my accounts already. So let's have a look here. Yep, this one's correct. Oh, look, there's a place to add an attachment. So if you have a receipt of some sort that you would like to record against this expense, you can add the attachment here. Then you'll have it for tax returns or whatever else you need it for in the future, or even for billing out to clients. So I'm going to match this one. It's disappeared. Let's open up this one. Match. Disappeared, and this one. Match, and it's disappeared. So now what have we got left here? These are the ones that we need to work out where they go. QuickBooks, once again, has, you know, it's used its brain to try to work out how these things should be processed. Now we need to review them and see if it's correct. So first of all, here I have some QuickBooks charges, web subscription costs, that looks correct. Upwork, yep, they do my video editing. Probably done this one. That one's correct. Annual fee, bank charges. See, QuickBooks gets pretty clever. Oh, now look at this one here, StubHub. That's definitely personal. So I'm going to expand it out here. I'm going to, now what I do with my personal expenses is I put them against my petty cash. I sometimes spend money for the company myself. So then this here will just be offsetting that. You might want to set up a loan account or something that is where you kind of put your personal expenses. So I'm going to add this one in here. And I want to record it because I want all of the transactions in so that I can do a full reconciliation when we're done. Now here we have line two, that's my telephone, that's correct. This one here, Sunny D, this is not office supplies. This was training. Training actually for making videos like this. Oh, I have to choose tax. Now, I believe she's exempt in the US, so I'm going to put that, but I will come back and I will check that later. But for now, let's go with that. Upwork again, yes, that's video. Subscription costs is correct. And here we have an interest adjustment. So I'm going to put that against the interest expense that it would be offsetting, because it's an adjustment to expenses we had before. Okay, so all of these entries have now been reviewed and classified, so I'm going to accept them. Oh, I think we have to pop in here to accept them, do we? Now, for all of these transactions here that we were just happy with where they went, we do need to actually add these. So we'll click in, add, and it wants to know what the GST is. So because this is, once again, a US purchase, exempt. And no, we don't want that to be the default for my web subscription costs because a lot of those are actually Canadian. Upwork, once again, this is an exempt one. Most of the time I have my the categories or the vendors set up so that this is already done when it comes in. That makes it a lot easier when you move forward. Wow, a lot of these US expense. Oh, it's my US dollar credit card. Of course, most of these are US. That makes complete sense now, doesn't it? Here we go again, add this, exempt. This one here will probably want a GST, yes it does, but this one's a US, so it's exempt. And the annual fee does not have GST on it, that's exempt also. So normally you'd want to know what tax code you were using for all the different expenses and just make sure they were put in here. So now if we have a look at this in QuickBooks tab, we can see all of these items that we just gone through have all been accepted into QuickBooks. So now when we go, we can reconcile our account and it'll have everything hopefully posted. So we can do that together next time.
Hopefully that's taken some of the mystery out of what to do with your transactions after you've imported them. Remember, if they don't belong there, you can exclude them. However, if you're reconciling your account and have personal charges, it's better to post them to your loan or personal account so your records are complete. Next time, we'll reconcile the account. If you'd like to sign up for QuickBooks, you can do so using the link below. If this has been helpful, be sure to click like and subscribe to my channel. And if there's anything else you'd like to know about, please make a note in the comments below, and my next video could be for you. Cheers.